In this video, we look at 10 smaller laser cutting projects we did over the last year. Number 1. Cable organizer. This super simple shape comes in handy when organizing cables. Just wrap the cord around the middle part and it's all neatly organized. The cable organizer is a very simple FreeCAD design. You will find links to download the SVG for this shape and all other parts on my website. Link in the description. Number 2. Stamps. The laser engraves linoleum quite nicely. Just remember to mirror the image before engraving it. With a small piece of wood, you can create all kinds of stamps. It's a really nice way to give things a more personal touch. Number 3. Boxes, boxes and more boxes. Creating boxes with a few mouse clicks is one of the most useful features of the laser cutter. We have been cutting boxes for electronics parts, holders for the remote control of the air conditioner, organizers for notes, organizers for ear sticks, and even this beautiful hinged box to protect an hourglass. Most of these are created with the boxes.py library and then modified in Inkscape. Number 4. Toy Doghouse. This doghouse is basically also only a box from MDF with a cutout at one side and an angled top. However, after gluing a few coffee stir sticks on the surface and painting them brown, it no longer looks like a boring MDF box, but like a wooden chat. The rubber foam for the shingles cuts very well on the K40 laser cutter, and as we always cut an entire row and not individual shingles, the roof is covered quite quickly. The dogs love their new home. Number 5. Advent calendar. This was a really nice Christmas project for the grandparents. First, we cut some doors into a sheet of graph paper. My kids create a beautiful set of 24 individual artworks on a template that indicates with gray borders where to draw. Using two holes and alignment markers on the printout, we glue the pieces together. After writing the numbers from 1 to 24 on the doors, my parents got a very individual present. Number 6. Organizers. During the COVID pandemic, I thought it would be a good idea to have some grip training equipment next to my desk. To keep it neatly organized, I created a quick design in FreeCAD and created joints with the laser cut interlocking workbench. The organizer is glued together, gets a coat of paint, and now holds all my stuff neatly in place. Number 7. Christmas ornaments. If you can cut something on a scroll saw, you can also cut it on a laser cutter. These Christmas ornaments are a nice addition to our Christmas tree. Have a look at the website from Steve Gott for more scroll saw designs that work perfectly on the laser cutter as well. Number 8. Wargaming roleplay game building stuff. For our tabletop roleplay game, I've been using the laser cutter quite a lot. This building was designed in Inkscape and cut on the K40 laser cutter. With the finger joints, it is quick and easy to assemble the building. The decoration is cut from the same sheet, and with a bit of paint, the ruin is ready to be used on the table. Number 9. Maker dice. You can get wooden blank dies pretty cheap on Amazon. When engraving small objects, I usually cut a cardboard template so the die sits in a specific place. On these dies, I engraved a few things I could make. We could cut a modern design for the living room or 3D print a practical thing for the workshop. Number 10. Star Wars Lightbox. Cutting paper is so simple and precise on the laser cutter that it really sparks creativity. Here I am cutting a set of different layers of paper. From old boxes, I cut cardboard distance pieces. All these layers together then form a nice light box with a Star Wars motif. I hope you enjoyed these ideas. Check out the laser cutting playlist for more projects with detailed descriptions. Don't forget to subscribe, and thanks a lot for watching.